Welcome everyone for our next session will be Frederick Un Siling will share information with us in 2 minutes.
Hello, I will talk on the same project. It's following the project we just learned about. It's the next step of the project. The project computes routing, pedestrian routing, and we have to give instruction to the pedestrian to follow this route. And this project helps to enchant the route with landmark extracted from OpenStreetMap. What's the problem we try to solve? In routing, like car routing, there is something like in 20 meters, turn right. But when you are a pedestrian in complex area, you can give distance and just turn right, turn left. Train station are complex area, and you have to help more the pedestrian. So one solution is to help with description, like friend of any people in the street can give you. Turn right after the back way. It's more simple to understand and to follow. What is the context? The context is pedestrian in the station or in the surrounding area of the station. For example, you are coming with a train and you are trying to catch to take a coach outside the station, and you have to go out to go somewhere in the surrounding and find the bus station. The train station has complex area, are multi-level, there is indoor, outdoor. The subject of enchantment of routing is a new subject. There is some article publication, but there is just nascent. There is, for example, no research on the indoor and outdoor at the same time. So we have two notions to understand for this is a landmark notion. What is a landmark? A landmark is something in the landscape that you can refer. And it's something that is different from the surrounding. You can identify it. You can see it. You can refer to it. And the science. The science is the relevance to a landmark to be usable. Now, if you have multiple pole in the street, you can use pole in the street. If you have large bakery, large art in the middle of the street, you can use it because a piece of art may be something prominent, something you can refer and unique. So we try to extract this kind of feature from OpenStreetMap. This kind of feature have different nature if you are inside or outside. We do not refer to indoor and outdoor because in the train station, you can be outdoor with nothing and you can see the sky, but you are inside the train station. You are still inside a complex area. So we not use inside and outside, but indoor and outdoor, but inside and outside. And we are not extracting the same landmark if you are inside or outside. The landmark are extracted from OpenStreetMap simply with filtering on tags. And for each landmark, we try to affect a weight. A weight will be used to select relevant landmark. The weight is based on multiple properties of object, like size, prominence, discoverable. If the object can be, you can see the object day and night. If the object, not the name of the object, but if the object has a visible name and you can refer to it. And then some semantic structural. Familiarity and ambiguous is if I tell you something, if I tell you a pharmacy, you know what is a pharmacy. And unambiguous is if you think to a pharmacy, do you will be able to see the pharmacy if you are at it? There is something, some element easier to see than other. Pharmacy is easy. Emergency call phone may be red, but may be small. So it may be hard to find. And then the structural, there is big object, like a supermarket, a small object, like emergency phone. So to set weight on all these properties and determine a global weight, we based on questionnaire and evaluation from participants to build a matrix for each object. We set a score on each of these categories and then build weight for inside and for outside. So, the goal is not just to extract from a process map, but be able to use it as landmark. And OpenStreet Map need to be reworked to do this. Where we are outside, sometimes the landmark are only nodes, not always a polygon or building. So we have to project the node in the position to be visible from outside. A node can be behind another building, but can be inside the building. So we have to find a closed door, and then we project the node on the closed door. And if there is not closed door, we project it directly on the front edge of the building. So with building and other building, we can hide or not landmark. So when you are on the street, you can see some projected landmark on the front edge or the door or not. And we do the same thing for inside. But inside, we have other rules because the inside is more complicated. There is room inside. If the landmark is in the room, it's a node or way, but in the room, we are considering you have to be in the room to see it. We do not do projection. But if it is a room, the full room is be used as a landmark, you can see it from outside. There is something on the door, on guichet, that, and you can see it from the door. But from the outside of the building, you can see the room inside if there is no door to go outside or inside. So we have to limit the visibility of the room from inside the building, not outside the building. So we reduce the size of the room a little to make something like the walls. And so if there is door that going outside of the room, but outside of the building also, we report the tags on the door. So we can see the room from outside. Then we have derived landmark from OpenStreetMap data, and we need to be able to show is a landmark visible or not from a point of view. The point of view is the path of the routing computed by the routing engine. So from a place, we use your ray casting. We trace line from the user position from every landmark surrounding on circle. And we check if the, there is on the same level and if there is no other element blocking the visibility, intersecting the ray. So there is a physical intersection like a building, other room or barrier. There are construction, art, and there is other soft blocking visibility. You can see on the other side of the ray. You can see on other on the other way of the other side of a waterway. But if I give you instruction to go to a place, I do not use something you can go by foot. You have to cross the ray. Is no. So only think on the same side I use. Then, as a duplicate object can limit the usability. If you have multiple, for example, bench in the rail station, there is bench everywhere. You can use bench to give instruction. But if there are group clustering of bench, you can group this and use the benches as a landmark. So we clustering small object, only a few objects, but small. There are on the same level and not separated by a wall or room. And then we clustering as only one landmark. It's to get more landmark. Because even if the station or around there is a lot of things, not all of things are usable as landmark. The route to follow is divided by in step, and you have you have step and decision making, like going outside of the station, you pass a door, a big door, and you have to ensure the user that it's a right path. So before making this decision. A bit far, but not too far. It depends on if you are inside or outside. You are giving instruction. So the visibility point is a bit before the decision point, the real decision point. So we have a point of view on the decision point. And so we have a lot of landmarks around. And we need to select a best landmark using the relative position and so on, and the weight we set before. So if we are changing of the level, we cannot use landmark because we have not visibility of the other side of the stair or elevator. So we going to the stair and net takes the stair and there is another step. There is a different distance for selecting landmark if we are inside or outside. Outside the visibility is larger. And we select only landmark to avoid confusion. If you are already on the parking for taking a couch, and there is another kind of parking just close. First, we are in the parking is no more a landmark, and we cannot also use another landmark of the same kind that is very close, because it's perturbing for the user. With raycasting to validate and check all the landmarks, and based on the weight and relative position of the landmark from the user and the path to follow, to select the best landmark. I already take this. Here we have the decision point, the red. The blue dot in the middle, and where in function of where the landmarks are, we are using different scores. And also, when we try to make the transcription for your user with relative position, depending on where are the user, the decision point, and the landmark, to give instruction to the user. So that's the initial step to extract and enchant a routine. Was done this spring. And now this work is integrated in the application, but I give the talk to Céline to follow.
Yeah. Hear me? Okay, thank you. Yeah, thank you very much, Frederic, for this extensive talk about the algorithm for the landmark selection. What we did at SNCF is that two more challenges for this project. One, how to calculate the weight of each category of tag in OSM. This was done by Nathan Cabrol, who couldn't attend today, with a cognitive approach and an experiment on 98 participants. So we are still trying to see if it helps us to give best landmark. And there was also another work done by Charlie Bernard, who could also not attend, is the integration of landmarks into sentences that are understandable but by everyone. So this challenge combined a linguistic and geographic approach, and we achieved to have a routing engine for pedestrian that uses landmarks enhanced instructions. So now we think it's good enough to be tested. So we are launching an experiment with real users to challenge what we tried to do. And we hope that maybe next year we will have strongest results to present to you. So if you have any question or if you're interested in this project, do not hesitate to come and talk with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Frederic and Céline. We have about 10 minutes for a question. If anyone wants to ask a question, please raise your hand up.
Hello? Okay. How do you determine whether a landmark is visible? What information do you have that tells you whether something's actually visible?
The question is about the visibility?
Yes.
The objects are extracted from OpenStreetMap, the landmark, but also all the building, all the room, all the highway, the waterway that can block the visibility, or soft or hard. And we draw line from each position of the user and the possible landmark usable. And if the line between two are intercepted by building or so on, the landmark is not visible and excluded. And from the remaining landmark, we are picking and using the score of the landmark, established by the weight and the relative position and distance of the user and the landmark.
Is there any more question? Anyone? Okay. Thanks again, Céline and Frederic, to share interesting and your job with us. Thank you very much.